Ooh, wow, I just melted this guy with a swordfish.
Red down.
Get out of there, boy. I know that you unlock the ABR at level 55, or the swordfish at level 55, but you gotta... I also don't have any attachments on this gun right now. I literally almost just got a quad beat if I had more ammo. Yo, what is going on, guys? My name is Yankee and welcome back to a brand new video. So today we're gonna go ahead and compare the two burst weapons here in Call of Duty Black Ops 4, the ABR 223 going up against the Swordfish. Now this is a video that a lot of you guys have been asking me to make for quite some time now, so I'm pretty excited to go ahead and actually finally bring this out to you and compare these weapons and figure out which one is the better one to use here in Call of Duty Black Ops 4. So let's go ahead and, like we start every weapon comparison video, we're gonna start with the stats on each weapon. Starting first with the Swordfish, it has a 7 in damage, a 10 in range, 13 in fire rate, and a 14 in accuracy. So the stats there just sound super, super overpowered. I'm really excited to actually try this new weapon out. Moving over to the ABR now, it does have an 8 in damage, a 7 in range, 12 in fire rate, and a 9 in accuracy. So it's a little less accurate than the Swordfish, but it also is super, super powerful at the same time. So I'm actually really excited to try both of these weapons out. Before we get into some gameplay though, I do want to ask each and every single one of you guys, smack an early like on this video. If we can get up to 100 likes, it'd be really greatly appreciated. It helps the channel a ton. Also, let me know down in the comment section below what is another weapon that you would like to see compared here in the near future with our weapon comparison series. And if you guys are new to the channel, this is your first time ever watching one of our videos, make sure you subscribe to the channel as well. We're on that road to 17,000 subscribers. Hopefully we can hit that fairly soon. Without further ado, let's get into some gameplay. Let's try both of these weapons out. At the end of the video, I'm gonna let you guys know which weapon I think is better in certain situations, and then I'll let you let me know also in the comments below after this is video over which weapon you guys think is better overall. But without further ado, let's get into the gameplay. Let's try out both of these weapons and figure out which burst weapon is the better one to use here in Call of Duty Black Ops 4.
Ooh,
wow, I just melted this guy with a swordfish.
Red down.
Get out of there, boy. Take a seat, boy. We're literally annihilating the enemy team right now. What am I doing? I'm 10 and 4 with the swordfish.
UAV standing by.
Alright, the swordfish is actually starting to grow on me a little bit. I'm starting to play a little better with it.
Wasted.
Man's right here. I'm gonna call this UAV in. Can I get up this way? No, it's too high up, I think.
Hostile Nomad down.
I should have went for the headshot there. I'm so stupid, man! Swordfish is growing on me, man. I do like, I am liking this gun. I'm getting used to it a little more. Here we go. I'll take that headshot.
Reach out and take it.
Helicopter, one more kill, and I will get... I just need one more kill to get the strike team. They're right here. There's my strike team. Look at that. Look at that triple kill in the kill feed, baby. Oh man, we almost had him, dude. Yo, we're destroying with these 3-round burst guns though, man. We really are. Oh shoot, they're all back this way still? Come on. Oh, I really wanted this last kill. The dog ended up getting it, man.
He's dead.
Get out of there, boy.
Tag.
Take a seat, boy.
Sensor going live. Intel wins wars.
Why am I not healing up? Why is my character not healing it up?
UAV standing by.
Wasted. Intel wins wars.
My god, the swordfish. Played pretty well with it. This thing is pretty dang good, man. Honestly, the 3-round burst in this game, like, they're both really good. Which one, but guys, which one do you think is better? The ABR or the swordfish? Ever since I switched this thing, we're melting.
Just mesh mine
get that mesh mine out of here. Call this UAV in. Where are they at? Are they spawning right now? Oh, there's a bunch right here. They're gonna come right here. Oh, no, 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 no. Oh, no. I didn't even see him come up the stairs, dude. I think that's all it is.
Just a matter of, like, being able to watch it a little more than I do.
Sensor going live.
They have a dog. Oh my god, the dog's coming. The dog's coming.
RCXD.
I wonder if that's gonna stop the dog. I wonder if this barricade will stop the dog. Do you guys know? Thank you, that got me a kill. Oh my god, they're spawning right here.
Establishing UAV data splice.
Nice plays, dude. I mean, so we played well with this, when we switch over to Swordfish. I think the Swordfish is honestly really freaking good, man. I haven't used it too often. I'm about to start using this thing a lot more. We literally got to play the game with it, too. Look at this thing. This thing's just shredding. We might have to switch over to the ABR in a second and see which gun is better, man. We might have to do that. I have no attachments on this gun, so it's gonna be a little rough at first. We're playing TDM though. This gun with no attachments is kind of a pain in the butt. Where are these fools at? They don't want to mess, I'll tell you that much. They don't want to mess with Yankee.
Sensor data up.
Oh god, somebody's right here.
Entanglement ahead.
No way. No way. No way. You're killing me.
Sensor dot out. Talk kill.
Teammate.
To hide.
I think that was a kill. I don't want them to spawn here.
Enemy switch.
And they did.
Enemy UAV.
Get that Maddox real quick. Just having a second gun. It's the only issue. At least we have, I think we have scavenger. We better have scavenger on this gun. Somebody right here? Somebody is right here. Let's see if we can get around him. See if we can flank him real quick. Woo! Oh, they're behind me! What, did they just spawn there? No way! He literally just spawned right there, man. My man just got a quad feed. My man legitimately just got a quad feed with that thing. Why is that thing so powerful? What do you guys think of the specialists in this game? Do you guys think they're too overpowered? Like, honestly, I'd be perfectly fine with seeing a game mode without any specialists. Nope, this guy's got body armor.
Enemy hellstorm detected.
Should have seen that coming.
Yeah, you should have seen that one coming, man. All right, there's always a lot of people on this alleyway, so.
Enemy UAV above.
You got a UAV. Enemy UAV. Oh my god, guys, this ABR is unbelievable. What is my record right now? 12-4? And this is with no attachments on this gun either. I really personally believe that the specialists in this game, they're just too annoying. Like, if there was just like a game mode that had no specialists at all, I think it would make things, the game, a lot more fun to play. Two bursts, point blank, doesn't kill him. It's gotta be nice, man. There's gonna be two of them right here. There we go, we got a new camo. That's our first camo with this thing. I feel like headshots in this might be a little easy because it has a lot of kick, it seems like.
Pulse going out.
Look at how many people are right here.
Enemy UAV above.
Look at how many people are right here, dude.
Enemy RCXD in your AO.
Move up. Tagged and bagged.
Dude, that should have been a kill. Shoot. Yo, we're playing pretty... This ABR, man. Oh, my goodness. We're not even playing with operator mods or anything yet, either. That's the sad part, dude. This gun could be 10 times better with the operator mod. But, dude, guys, let me know down in the chat which gun do you guys think is better. I know that you unlock the ABR at level 55, or the Swordfish at level 55. But you gotta... I also don't have any attachments on this gun right now. We literally almost just got a quad feed if I had more ammo. If I had extended mags, I would have had a quad feed with that. Dude, this ABR might be better.
You know what to do.
I'm gonna try and flank. Oh. Oh my goodness.
Attack choppers.
Give me the chopper. Should we use the chopper? Yeah, let's use this.
Requesting attack chopper support.
Got a strike team. Look at us, baby. Look at us taking over the game. Literally taking over the game. First game using the ABR. We've already leveled it up 4 times. We're going off with the damn thing. Yeah, dude, this gun is ridiculous. This gun is so good. Okay. 2 strike team kills. Let's get it. They're gonna spawn behind us. I'm sticking with this gun, dude. Point blank. Woo! Free kills, baby. Go strike team, go baby, there we go. We end up losing the game, but we still managed to drop 34 kills there, man. Guys, I don't know. I really don't know. Which gun do you think is better? Is it the Swordfish or is it the ABR? We literally, with both guns, we're just absolutely destroying them. We just gotta figure out which one is better, though. Definitely let me know what you guys think down in the comments. Which gun is better, the Swordfish or the ABR? I know the Swordfish you unlock it at level 55, but we literally had no attachments on that ABR at all, and we were destroying them. Literally, like, we never got more than a 2-burst kill. With the Swordfish, there sometimes we're getting 3 bursts, and we still were getting like a bunch of hit markers. So I don't know, man. I think if I had to choose one of these, I would definitely go with the ABR, but I don't know. Definitely let me know what you guys think down in the comments, man.